एम्ब्रेप्सिया प्लेसेंटा। बट बिफोर दैट वी शुड नो व्हाट इज प्लेसेंटा एक्रीटा इन्फ्रीटा एंड प्रैंटीटा। व्हेन द प्लेसेंट इन प्लेसेंटा प्रीविया व्हेन अ प्रीवियस यूटराइनस कार द विलाई में इन्वेड नितंबुश लेयर रिजल्टिंग इन प्लेसिना। So what is, this is the normal placenta and this is the attachment of placental membrane at the decidua basalis. In accreta, the placenta is abnormally attached directly to the myometrium. Dikhta mera purse? Okay. Like this. The placenta is abnormally attached directly to the myometrium. It is called placenta accreta. Now, in increta, the placenta invades the myometrium. The cursor is here. Just look at the cursor. And in pancreta, the placenta invades the myometrium and goes beyond the myometrium. Now, this is the photograph of abruptio placenta. The first photograph is of placenta previa when the placenta is implanted in the lower uterine segment or just over the cervical internal os. This is complete type of placenta previa and there is bleeding, that is placenta previa. When the placenta is situated normally at the fundus and it is detached and there is bleeding, it is called abruptio placenta. Understand? So what is the definition? Bleeding occurs due to premature separation of normally situated placenta. It is called abruptio placenta. And it is, there are three types of abruptio placenta. First one is revealed. Following separation of placenta, blood insinuates downwards between the membrane and the decidua. That means the bleeding which is happening at the level of placenta trickle down and comes through the cervix. Second one is concealed type of abruptio placenta. In this, blood collects behind the separated placenta or collected in between the membrane and decidua. So there may be no bleeding at present, but bleeding is internal inside the uterine cavity and there is no bleeding through the cervix or the vagina. Then third one is mixed type. Some part of collection inside, that is concealed, and some part of bleeding is expelled out, that is revealed. So it is a mixed type. That means bleeding is there. It may be 1 liter, 500 ml is out and 500 ml is remain inside the uterine cavity. So these are the three types: revealed, concealed and mixed. Now, mechanism of separation of placenta is shown here. Partial separation, this is the normally situated placenta. There is detachment here and bleeding and it is trickled down through the cervix. The A diagram is showing partial separation, right? Then there is marginal separation in the second photograph. There is separation of placenta. Placenta is folded out and there is bleeding. And the third one is complete separation of placenta and there is no bleeding outside the vagina, that is a concealed type of bleeding. So what was the etiology? In cases of antepartum hemorrhage in placenta previa, we have discussed the etiology. The etiology for abrasio placenta are high birth order of pregnancies, advancing age of mother more than 35 years, poor socioeconomic condition, malnutrition, anemia, smoking, placenta previa, eclampsia, preeclampsia, trauma, external cephalic version, road traffic accident, amniocentesis, sudden uterine compression because of delivery of first baby in cases of twin pregnancy, sudden escape of lycoemia in cases of hydronephrosis, and premature rupture of membrane by any cause. Then short cord, supine hypotension syndrome, folic acid deficiency, torsion of uterus, drug abuse, and thrombophilias. These are the positive factors for abrasion of placenta. Now, pathogenesis is hemorrhage into the deciduo bacillus that leads to decidual hematoma. That leads to rupture of basal plate, communication of hematoma with the intervillous space. There is lack of contraction of uterus and compression of torn bleeding points, that is torn uterine sinuses, and that is leads to descended by the contractor. So that leads to bleeding and collection of blood inside the uterine cavity. Initiation of bleeding into the decidua bacillus. This bleeding splits the decidua and decidua hematoma forms. The hematoma leads to separation, compression, and disruption of placenta adjacent to it. So gradually, slowly, the placenta is separated, whole of the placenta is separated from the its attachment. The process may be self-limited with no further complication to the pregnancy, or it may be continued to become catastrophic. Bleeding insinuates between the fetal membranes and the uterus, which may exacerbate or may remain concealed. Concealed abrasion can often be more compromising to membranic status, since they are generally underappreciated. That means we have not diagnosed how much of bleeding is going inside the uterine cavity, and that is more dangerous type. That means concealed is more dangerous. The risk factors are again increasing age and parity, hypertension, preterm rupture of membranes, multiple gestation, polyhydramnios, smoking, drug abuse, prior abruption, pregnancy with uterine fibroid, and any trauma that leads to abruption. Now, clinical presentation. First is vaginal bleeding. There may be constant and severe abdominal pain, irritable, tender, and typically hypertonic uterus, evidences of fetal distresses, if severe leads to intrauterine death, maternal shock, DIC, up to 20% of placental abruption, it is concealed type. This is the sonography where you have seen the placenta is marketed and there is retroplacental hemorrhage. Below that is uterus, myometrium, then hemorrhage, and then you have seen placenta. This is myometrium. This is hematoma and that is placenta. Now, how will you diagnose the case of abruptio placentae? Clinically, late trimester painful bleeding. Placenta previa, the bleeding is painless. Right? In abruptio, the bleeding is painful. The placenta is normally situated. In placenta previa, placenta is low-lying. Or you know four types of placenta. There may be DIC that leaks, may be a cause of bleeding, and you can diagnose it by ultrasonography. And I already told you, any bleeding in third trimester, we have to examine her after starting of IV line and preparation for cesarean section. That is double setup examination. Right, now we come to clinical classification. Grade 0, clinical feature may be absent. Diagnosis made after inspection of placenta following delivery. That means baby is delivered out, then the placenta is delivered out, and after that clots, blood clots may be removed. So we can see, oh, there was a bleeding inside the uterine cavity, but it is diagnosed only after delivery. That is grade 0. Now grade 1, external bleeding is slight, uterus is irritable, tenderness is there or maybe not present, shock is absent and fetal heart sound is good. In grade 2, external bleeding mild to moderate, uterine tenderness is always present, shock is absent, fetal distress or even fetal death can occur. Now grade 3, bleeding is moderate to severe or may be concealed, that means there is maybe no bleeding at all. Uterine tenderness is marked, patient is in shock, fetal death is there. When we do investigation, coagulation defect we can diagnose, and there may be anuria, that means acute renal failure is there. Now we come to differential diagnosis. Reveal type differential diagnosis is of course placenta previa. In mixed or concealed type of abruptio placenta, the differential diagnoses are ruptured uterus, rectus sheath hematoma, appendicular or intestinal perforation, twisted ovarian tumor, volvulus, acute hydromnias, tonic uterine contraction. Because in abruptio placenta, uterus is always very irritable and very tender. Investigations which are necessary are hemoglobin, usually low volume proportionate to blood loss in cases of reveal type of placenta. But if it is concealed, the patient is look pale but there is no bleeding. This may, patient may complain with this type of abruption also. So coagulation profile, clotting time is increased more than 6 minutes. Fibrinogen level is low, that is less than 150 milligram per deciliter. Platelet count is low. Partial thromboplastin time increased. FDP and D dimer increased. Urine for protein may be present if it is because of preeclampsia, eclampsia or hypoplasia. Now come to complications. maternal complication are hypovolemia that lead to shock, DIC, renal failure, rupture, and that leads to maternal death. Fetal causes are hypoxia, anemia, intrauterine growth retardation, and intrauterine fetal death. Management may be conservative, emergency cesarean section, or vaginal delivery, depending on the condition of the mother and the baby and the gestational age. Now, emergency cesarean delivery is ideal if maternal or fetal geopardy is present. As soon as the mother is stabilized, we have to do cesarean section. Sometimes we have to do cesarean section before this because we have to save mother and baby both. For vaginal delivery, the bleeding is heavy, but now it is controlled. Or pregnancy is more than 36 weeks, perform amniotomy, induce labor, place external monitor to assess fetal heart rate pattern and contractions. If it is everything is normal, then it will deliver normally. Avoid cesarean delivery if the fetus is dead. But sometime we have to do cesarean section in cases of IUD also. And always prepare emergency facility for emergency LSCS operation anytime. Then conservative in hospital for observations. If the mother and the fetus are stable, now bleeding is stopped, they are removed from term, bleeding is minimal or decreasing or stopped, and the contractions are subsiding, confirm normal placental implantation with sonogram and replace blood loss with crystalline blood products as needed, and conserve it till 36 weeks of pregnancy. Now, what is cobilar uterus? It is a severe form of concealed apraxial placenta. It is a massive intravascular of blood in the uterine musculature up to the serosal cord. This condition is only diagnosed by laparotomy while doing cesarean section. There is a nice photograph of cobilar uterus in your book. Go through it. Now, in summary, abruptio placenta pain is always there. In placenta previa, it is absent. The risk factors in abruptio are previous abruption, hypertension, trauma, and drug abuse. Placenta previa, it is previous history of previous placenta, multiparity, structure abnormalities like fibroid, advanced age. Diagnosis by sonography, placenta is normal position. There may be presence of retroplacental hematoma and clots in abruptio placentae. In placenta, as I told you, placenta is implanted over the lower uterine segment. That's all for today. Thank you. Okay.